How she survived. That's good.
never thought my son would ever get married. That's a miracle. which is just fantastic. But last week I was telling my sister Rania that I woke up in the middle of the night, and I was going downstairs, got dressed and everything, but something just didn't feel right. And so I went out to go to my car, and my garage door was up, and I'm going, what in the world? The first thing I thought of was fear. And I'm going, what in the world is going on? So Aaliyah had got up, and so I said, what am I going to tell her? Because I don't feel right in there. So I went to back up my driveway. Something said, don't leave. Went back in the house, hollered upstairs, told Aaliyah to come downstairs. So the first thing I did was lock the door because I didn't want to scare her. And I know what was going on, said, don't do that. You gotta tell the truth. So I told her that something in the garage door was up. I got up, and so I don't feel right going outside and leaving her here. So when she got ready to leave, I pulled out and I went to go off the road. So she said, don't leave. So I sit there in the middle of the road and kept turning around waiting for her to come out. And when she came out, she was running. She had both backpacks on her back. And so I backed up and I'm going, Maria, what's wrong? She said, Mom. She said, I'm locked out. I said, what do you mean you're locked out? She said, my keys are in the house. My garage door has never been up and hasn't been up since. That's why I know God is good, because yes, I would have went to Washington, D.C., and my daughter would have been standing outside. That's how good God is. He will come when you want him. Yeah. And when some people say, not on time, this was on
time.
Because like I said, my daughter would have been outside, and I would have been in Washington, D.C. So that's how good God is, because normally I back out and keep going. He wouldn't let me go. So I'm just saying, God has worked miracles in my life, with my son, with my niece. So I just want to say, God, I just want to say, church, God is good.
Yes, he is.
Praise him.
Yes, ma'am.
In the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon, because he's listening. And I know sometimes you say, well, God, I pray, but God can't hurt you. God hears you.
Yes, he does.
Just because he comes when we don't, you know, when he's not on time, we don't think he's on time. God is good. And Pastor, I sat there last week and I just sit there in the midst of this, knowing I should have praised him, but I didn't. But I said, this week, I'm not going to go on.
Thursday night, Cousin Cox, and she said, I bet they were looking at you like you were crazy.
said, yes, they were. And you can see the faces of people looking at you in the other cars when you done stop or something like that. So I am just grateful to God that we are still here. And each car just broke so we can get across the highway. Also, I was talking to a lady, Anita, Sister Anita. She was telling me, I would give her testimony. She had done a 360 on 97 with a tractor trailer and somehow just maneuvered and did not hit her. She was on a slippery road. And that's how we got on the conversation about these cars. And for some reason, the roads were slippery. She, I don't know what happened. She said she rounded up going at 360 on 97 and just so grateful that God kept her off.
Amen. Amen.
I give God all the honor, glory, and praise.
Well, I ain't gonna sit down on this opportunity. I do it all the time. But as y'all can see, the hallway and the multi-purpose room is done. It was at a cleaning week. I called Dougie and just call him one time, he's there for me. We started at 6:30 yesterday morning. We moved everything out of the building. I said, oh man, what are we gonna do now? We're not gonna work. I said, man, how can I ask this man to come help me put this stuff back? We finished work about 5:30, something, 6. We came back down and mowed the grass. I said, man, I still got to get this stuff back here. Before I could ask him, he told me, partner, what time are we going to be here Sunday morning? Mm-hmm. Now, we work all day Saturday. 6:30, he's back down here waiting. So I just like to say, thank you, Dougie, for being here, boy. No question to ask all the time. Yeah, just thank you.
Said I wasn't going to tell nobody. But all these testimonies this morning, God told me to say something. I got to say something. I just want to say continue to praise God. I've seen what he's done for me. I don't know what he's done for you. I've seen what he's done for me. I know one day that I'm going to be all right. I'll be walking all right. I know whether it's going to be on earth or it's going to be in glory. But wherever it be, I know God will make a way. And I want y'all to continue to praise God. Keep me in your prayer, my wife, and all our families. That's in Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Dougie, keep up the good work.
She's always in the money pile. Not always doing her things irresponsible, just doing. Single mom, doesn't have a lot of money, trying to get her children all that she can. So lately, she got in mind because she was helping her daughter go through her first year of college. She just wanted to get them. Even when I heard her tell me, I said, this is not a good idea. So it was not, but she did get her budget. Well, Uncle Sam came through first, and he took his money, so that made the credit card back for the government. So, of course, you know how that goes up the chain at your job, and she got to the point where they could, you know, do an investigation on her, and that's close to getting fired. So she was, you know, telling me about this all along, and I personally just don't have the money to give her. But she was really upset because, you know, she got to the end to this part where it was going to go to investigations. And she said she called her pastor because they're very close, and she was crying, and she was like, where are my angels? Because let me tell you, even though she has no money, she pays her tithe. The 10% that we're supposed to pay, even though she doesn't have money, she pays it. So I came home and told Rich about it, because she's really close to family too, and he was like, well, how would you give her money? And I said, because she didn't ask me for the money or anything. And I said, she'll pay you back. He said, she doesn't even have to pay me back, because I don't want her to lose her job, because she's everything.
I'm just saying and ask the church to continue to pray for me.
Linda's testimony. Linda's pretty shy. She didn't do a whole lot of talking. But I'm going to tell you the miracles God has worked in Linda's life. I met Linda when my sister-in-law had cancer and passed away. Linda was sick herself. She was taking care of my sister-in-law. And that's how we became friends. Linda had cervical cancer. She's had surgery twice. She is doing awesome now. Linda has had neck surgery twice. Linda is doing awesome. She has pain, you know, achy, cloudy, and all that, but she's doing well. Linda had surgery on her neck in June for a mass that she had on her neck, and she's doing wonderful. Linda was going through a lot with insurance. She is paying out of pocket for her insurance, which is astronomical.
Yes.
She has to pay a $40 copay for every time she goes to the doctors. And let me tell you, Linda goes to the doctors 5 or 6 times a month. And I know because I take her. And that is a hardship on her. But she sent me a text and said, I am so excited, but I can't tell you until I see. I said, girl, you ain't sending me no text telling me you got something to tell me or make me wait until you see me. That's not going to happen. What's going on? And she told me that she had gone to the health department and some lady there, she was going down there just to see if she could get Medicaid. Some lady down there said to her, I'm really not supposed to do this, but I'm going to help you out. I'm going to do something for you. So she is so excited that she will be getting Medicaid and get rid of all of those astronomical bills.
Before she went, she said she had fallen. I'm like, okay, well, what did they say? she was only taking it once a week before. That didn't mesh with her other medicine, so that was making her stomach upset and making her not have appetite and all that caused a common problem. But I told her about the hip. I said, I don't know why they told her not to worry about the fracture in her hip. So they said, that's crazy. I don't know either. So they sent her to the orthopedic doctor and they said, no, we're going to send her to Suburban Hospital. She needs to have surgery. Okay. So they sent her to Suburban Hospital. She had the surgery. They put a pin in her hip. And now she's at the rehab in Genesis Crescent Center on Riverdale Road. She's there. I went to visit her and she said everything was going. She was feeling better. She was eating. She was feeling better. So now she just has to do therapy and rehab. So I just want to say God is good. Yes, he is. And he's on time because, I mean, even her daughter goes to see her and stuff like that. She works. She has kids. So sometimes she don't get to see her and everything. So I'm just glad that he sent me there. They told her she was dehydrated really bad. Then give her 4 bags of IV. That's how dehydrated she was. So I just thank God that he sent me there.
Sometimes our allegiance to a team is handed down. When I went to, about 5 years ago, from the last time the Raiders beat the Redskins, I was in Oakland. I went to the game at the Oakland Stadium. And it was amazing to me that all the little kids, the little bitty kids, were all dressed to the nines in silver and black Raiders. I'm talking about this girl, she came with a baby in arms. Baby was maybe 4 months old, had on Raiders stuff. All her kids, and 4 kids, every kid she had on Raiders stuff. And the little bitty baby was running around talking about just win, baby. Just win, baby, which is the motto of the Raiders. And so I was just truly amazed at how, from birth, they started the Walker fans. Now some of y'all, it might have been a favorite player, it might have been the only game in town, it might have been the team that you watched on TV, it might have been the team that won a bunch of championships, but whatever it is, you became a member of a fan of the team. But today what we have heard here, and what I want to put in perspective, and I'm really not going to be too long, because we have heard the Bible says that faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word, and by what we've heard today in the testimony, we know how great God is. Amen. We know what God did. But I want to remind everyone that even though no matter what jersey you're wearing, no matter what colors that you're wearing, we are on a team too.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And so we are all members. Turn to your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
We are all.
On Team Jesus.
On Team Jesus.
Redskins fan. is a player who played for the Redskins. He was a first-round draft choice, second-round draft choice last year. He was going to be the starting safety this year, and Sua Cravens was making $1.1 million. But Sua Cravens decided that he did not want to play. And so, as unusual as it is, because it doesn't happen a lot, he just left the team. He left the team. And so the team had looked at him, and they had a slot for his gifts, and they had a slot for his talents. So now he left the team, which means it left a hole in what the team needed to do. Huh? And so it is with us, for those who are here, those who have been drafted by God, those who are supposed to be here, yet you choose not to play. You choose not to use your gifts and your anointing. And don't you dare complain that things are happening. How can things happen when there's a hole with your name on it? Oh, come on.
And so it's just like Joshua said to his people, choose ye this day who
the things that we do here. I want you to be willing to share. You see, at some point, and I was talking to Tyra about getting t-shirts for a bunch of the stuff that we do. I want to have t-shirts because I'm proud to show off. I'm from St. Matthew's. I'm proud. Amen. I want to get bumper stickers because I'm tired of seeing cowboy bumper stickers and nothing against cowboys. Yes, there is something against cowboys. But anyway. but I'm tired of seeing bumper stickers and flags and all this stuff for all these people who give you absolutely nothing. And as a member of Team Jesus, you get all that you have. He said,
show you
it comes. Guess we gotta put up a blood stain down. Because I don't know about you, but I'm just real glad what Jesus has done for me. Proud to be a member of Team Jesus. So Lord God, as we leave this place today, let us always know that you have drafted us and pulled us into the miraculous. And even if we can't see it, it's happening all around us. The angels all around us. Hallelujah. The love, the power, the joy all around us. Because we are members of his marvelous team. So Lord God, we thank you. In the midst of darkness, let us not forget we're still members of the team. In the midst of things not going our way, we're still members of the team. And as members of the team, here's what we know. And I thank you for the testimonies today so that everybody will know God is able. Somebody say, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
God is able.
Yes, he is.
So we thank you. Hallelujah. And give you all the glory. All the honor and all the praise. Help us to continue to share the story. Not just here among the saints, but of those who are living in darkness. Help the glory of your story shine a marvelous light on them, so that they might know that it is Jesus who is the hope of the world. In the awesome name of Jesus, we pray this prayer. Thank you, Lord God, for drafting us. Thank you, Lord God, for keeping us. And help us, Lord God, to be participants on your team. Team Jesus. In the awesome name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And we say amen.
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 And amen. Can you give the Lord?
Upcoming events and join us anytime. See you next Sunday. Team Jesus.